Hey everybody, this is Israel again with Austin Boats and Motors. Today I'm going to be showing you this LSZ 2485 VRB Avalon pontoon boat. It's a 2021 model, just came off the truck. So this is a pretty popular model for this area that we're in. I think it just has such a versatile layout that it just makes it very popular with families who need a boat that can change in a moment's notice for their needs that day. While we're up here at the front, I want to go over a few things up here that Avalon does to really make their boats just that much better and kind of clean up the look of it. So as you can see on the outside, there's no exposed railing. That's something that a lot of new boat owners don't really take into consideration. If you don't know, you don't know, you know, but when cleaning a boat, when you have all that exposed railing, a lot of dirt and other things likes to get stuck back there. So it's like power washing. You know, every time you go over that spot, you see dirt come out, but then you go back over it again, the dirt still keeps coming out, keeps coming out, keeps coming out. So it makes it nice, just one pass. You don't have to go back over it several times to get all the dirt out of the railing. Also up here in the front, you've got your chrome docking light assembly with the navigation lights tied into it. So it leaves this whole front wall area very clean and free of obstruction. Nothing sitting on the ground. Up here you've got some removable corner caps. These are also very nice. Inevitably things, even for the best of us driving boats, things happen and things get damaged. They make these where you can, if you end up hitting these, this is one of the most heavily damaged areas on all pontoons. You can replace those and not need to replace a whole strip. I've seen some other boats like that that have a wraparound railing. So if you dent in the corner, your choices are to either replace the whole thing, which you have to take that into a shop to do, or if you get a boat like this, this is pretty simple. Anyone at home could do this. Another really cool thing is take a look at this right here. See how flat it is up at the front. Everything's tucked in with the exception of that bow strap right there that's attached to the trailer. When this thing is in the water, there's nothing up here other than this tie-on area that is exposed. So this is one of the most safest options out there in the market. Very clean front deck. This is a very heavily trafficked area when you're out there with the kids in the cove. They're always on and off the boat, in the front, off the front, jumping off. And last thing you want is an exposed hook in the front for your pontoon or anything over here on the front where they're going to be jumping off. Now, this is somewhat of a necessity because you'll need to tie off on places. So they've made really huge strides in trying to make this a lot more safer for family-oriented situations. Coming down the side here, take a look at that clean finish. They've got some chrome accent pieces on the side. It's a nice touch. And over here towards the back. So this is going to be powered with a Suzuki 140. This has been a very popular option in recent years. Suzuki is right up there with Mercury and Yamaha with their reliability. And a motor like this is plenty of power for this boat. Get you where you want to go. It won't feel you earning for more power. So very nice, reliable motor that you can count on every day. And back here, we've got a four-step ladder. And moving into the boat, we have a ski tow bar right here where you can attach tubes, skiers. We'll go ahead and hop up in. I'll show you the rest of the boat. I'm going to stand back here on the back platform for just a second and kind of give you a good general view of the layout here. So back here, you've got your versatile rear bench slash sun pad. Moving forward, you have an L-shaped couch right next to the driver. Captain seat, and then up in the front is some lounge seating. So while we're back here, let's go ahead and start with this very interesting versatile rear bench layout back here. You've got some storage over here. It's a dry storage, so if you need to put things like towels or sunblock, that kind of stuff can go in here. Very easy access, and you also have some cup holders and some easy access storage right there as well. So moving on towards the back of this, you've got a couple different functions with this. So right now it is in a seat back position for the L couch, with a simple lift. It turns into storage, or a seat back for the sun pad. You still got some seating up here, but you've got a nice big sun pad now. There's actually one more position. This will fold all the way down. A lot of people like to use that. And in the event that you don't want to use it, you can always use this entire area underneath here for storage. So, huge storage compartment. Life jackets, I mean, you name it. Fenders, whatever you need to put underneath there, it all fit. And then moving back here, we've got a changing room area, privacy station. Right now I've got the cover back here. This is something you can leave at the dock, and then you'll have more storage as well as a privacy station. You can even throw in a porta potty right there, so that those longer days on the lake, you've got all your bases covered. Moving back into the captain's area here, we have some more storage. The seat back is going to be dry storage. All of the seating underneath here is going to be to the wall. So that's something not a whole lot of manufacturers do. I think it's Avalon and one other manufacturer who I will not name. So they make all of their seats out of aluminum framing. The wall is raised about, I don't know, a quarter of an inch, so that it allows for air to come in. So when you put wet things down here, you don't have to worry about when you come back out, it's gonna be all moldy and mildewy. And then of course the things that you absolutely need to keep dry, you can put them in this seat back right here. There's one right here and one up in the front of the boat. This one, we have put the option in it for a trash can. That makes it very nice. You have a nice designated area for trash. And then moving back over here to the driver's seat, we've got a very plush captain's chair that will swivel. And then up here on the dash, you have a nice wind protection. Very beautiful steering wheel, beautiful laid out helm, very wide, very easy to see and use. It's not all crammed together. You've got all your engine vitals in this area right here, your music, and then your depth finders right there. If you have any fishermen or kids that like to fish in the family, this is perfect. It's got a transducer already set up in the back, so you are already set up to go out and fish. You've got some more toggle switches over here. This is going to control the lights. So it's got exterior lights, docking lights, your mood lighting, which is going to be the blue lights inside the boat. Very cool feature for closer to the nighttime. I mean, this thing just lights up and it looks awesome. Down here, I'm going to show you the Coast Guard plate. We've got 12 people or approximately 1,800 pounds. So plenty of room for everyone. Up here, our front seats, this is all going to be stored as well. Then of course you have a table for those times where you want to have a picnic out on the lake or enjoy a glass of wine or something closer towards the evening. Nice open area. And then of course here's that dry storage area as well. And that pretty much wraps it up for this boat today. If you have any questions about this boat or would like more information or maybe a little more detailed showing of it, feel free to reach out to us. Again, my name is Israel, and this is Austin Boats and Motors. You can call us at 512-263-2811 or check us out on austinboats.com. Thank you.